There's something a familiar YouTuber once says, oops. Hello, it's your tech visitor's girl, Melody Tensei. And this right here is my personal USB that has clutched me through all of university. So if you're wondering what's inside this USB, it contains a set of applications that helped me through it because we got stupid thing called university rules on the computer. So what do you mean by that, Mel? Ask Mel. Back in university, had to use computers that were provided by the university in a computer lab and something like that. Imagine this, like little Mel's just walking around and she needs to grab a quick file from, say, a network attached storage from the university, but it's only accessible by those computers. So I gotta grab those. In theory, I would just grab the files, take it to my laptop and do the work there. But what if all I'm doing is just editing a file or something like a notepad or something like that. And then I gotta grab notes from, say, probably my students' website from their own servers, like a school servers, something like that. What if I wanna do all that? Okay, it should be pretty easy. You remember the password, right? Right? Now this is where I hit a roadblock. So it's 2020 at the time, and people started adopting the use of something we known as password managers. So I started scrambling all my passwords, and lo and behold, it came biting at me that I have to type every single password each time on those computers, and I have to spend like probably what, a whole minute to type my password down? Yeah, that's fucking insane. Unfortunately, no. Well, in case you're wondering what took a whole minute, it's a 16-character passcode. So, not to mention you got case sensitivity, numbers, symbols, they're all in factor. So, it took me that long to type. Yeah, little Mel had to go like, grab her keyboard and go, oh, well, let me just shift percent. Small t, wait, no, go back. Big T, yeah. Yeah, that's kind of the problem I ran into, and I didn't want to go through all that all the time, because what if someone needs the computer really quickly because there's a limited count of computers at some point? Or maybe I just want to be quick because I hate wasting time. This USB has saved me for a very, very long time, and it saved me a lot of times that I otherwise wouldn't have. So let's have a look at what's inside. Let's grab this and plug it in, I guess. Oh, before I'm plugging it in case you're wondering, I'm a big fan of tea. This is just an off-topic stuff, but I kind of like the show. Well, think about craft computing. You know how craft computing always has a beer at the end of videos? Well, how about have a tea for myself? Ahmed tea. Well, I'm just a big fan of drinking teas in general, so this is just one of my choices of the moment, because I'm not too big of a person who buys a lot of tea at one time and then drink them all at the same time. I would be a psychopath if I'd be drinking that much. But the boxes of tea that I currently have right now is a chamomile and lemongrass version. And I gotta be honest, it's kind of very refreshing and it gives you that calm vibes. And while you're editing, it just brings you down to tranquility sometimes. While you're editing, it's not so stressful. And yeah, I guess I just enjoy it in general. However, if you're wondering what's my top favorite tea, it would be the Taiwanese High Mountain Oolongs. Those give a serious, massive punch. It's kind of like an alternative to coffee, where the coffee gives you the energy punch, except in tea form. So that's kind of how I feel about Taiwanese High Mountain. Right, all the tea yapping out of the way, let's get back to the main part of the video. Right, I got my USB plugged in, and let's see what's inside. Oh, there's nothing here. Right. If you know me as a person who does a lot of experiments with tech, you know that I tend to clean up my USB a lot. Yeah, those are one of those days, you know? That means I think I probably have lost everything. Well, fear no more. We could probably just minimize that and open up the very program that we need. It's called PortableApps. So PortableApps.com allows you to have portable versions of your favorite apps in the USB or whatever hard drive you're gonna carry around. It's basically meant to be like a mini program of your choice wherever you go. It works on drives, it works on clouds, it works on anything, it works on, well, anything you can put it in, it works. With a small little caveat, I've only had prior experience with the Windows version of the app, so I can't really tell you anything about the Linux version or the Mac version. Because they say it also works with it via crossover wineskin wine bottler play on Mac. So your mileage may vary when you're on those platforms. However, we're gonna get into here and we're gonna start with downloading portableapps.com, and soon enough, we're gonna have an installer. So once you're done, open up the installer as per usual and oh look, Mallory is British. Okay, right, let's click on next and agree to the terms and yada yada yada. And what we're gonna do is click on a new copy, a new installation, and it's gonna ask you what type of installation you're gonna put it in a cloud, in a portable, or locals, all users, or anywhere you want. We're gonna pick portable, and it's gonna ask you which drive, which our case would be the D drive. Haha, D. Right, let's press install. Now we're gonna wait for it to finish installing. And then following that, it's gonna ask if you wanna run the program. And once you start, it opens up something like this. You got the About page, and then you got something that looks a little awfully like Windows 7 kind of start menu, except everything Portable Apps related. I'm gonna close that for now, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to... Oh, it has done it for us. I was gonna click on it, but it didn't let me. It just opened it up itself. Right, so we're gonna start grabbing things that we want. So say for example, I want my Chrome and Firefox. So we just go scrolling through the list and... Internet, we got Firefox Portable right here. We just tick that and then say I probably want something like Telegram desktop if you happen to use Telegram, and download whatever you want. There's even OBS Studio as well, that's surprising. And if you need VLC, they too have VLC. So you can see that there's a massive choice of applications that you can use. However, I did not use all of them, unfortunately. I did use a few, particularly Firefox, and I think that's pretty much it. Otherwise, it's kind of like my utility USB, if anything. But yeah, with that said, I'm gonna show you what I actually have, because I fucking lied to you in the beginning. I did not wipe my drive without knowing that I have my shit there. I have backed it all up. So I'm gonna bring them all back, and then I'm gonna present to you what I got. Right, so I've opened up my particular copy of Portable Apps, and well, it's been quite a while since I last updated anything, so there's some updates that it automatically came up as I opened it up, so let's press install on those. So it does most of it for you, however there are times where they will ask you to confirm your agreement to the EULA, because some apps require you to agree to the EULA before proceeding. So this process of installing apps are not 100% unattended, some of which requires your EULA attention, so please take note of that. So if you're planning on doing anything else while you're installing, please make sure to check back on your computer when you're doing that. Right, with the update done, I'm gonna click finish, and we can bring back our things. And now, I'm not sure if you can imagine what kind of person I am, but yeah, I downloaded everything. To the point that when I click this button, I'm only left with 3 programs to download brand new. I'll take care of that off camera. But what's more important is that you can fit a lot of programs. There's about over 50 gigs, just programs only. That's freaking insane. It's like you can just grab a 64 gig USB and throw everything on it, and booyah, you got yourself a hyper utility USB for anything, like tech support for your grandma, tech support for yourself, or a quick emergency schoolwork by borrowing someone's PC and then not installing it onto their computer so you can use your own. There's so many different things you can do with it, and there's everything like Notepad++. They got even LibreOffice as well, so you can do some of the office works. It's just super, super flexible as a program. And if you feel like it, you could probably also install your own portable apps and chuck it into the apps folder, but I'm not really too sure how that works because I installed an older version of OBS and threw it in and it somehow showed up for me, but not in my current case, but it did show up in the older case. Not sure about today though, however, but your mileage may vary. So this thing, considering being portable, which also means that if you load Firefox on it, it's not going to save into app data, it saves into its local folder as well. So that means I could also save my password managers in there. And I could get stuff copy and pasted very quickly without having to worry about needing to install another program. But Mel, doesn't that mean you're installing a program or using a third-party program on a computer? Technically, it's using third-party programs. However, in my university, it said nothing about installing anything. So I technically didn't install anything to the computer. I've only installed it to my USB for use on the USB. And I'm only piggybacking the processing power from the desktop that the university provided. Which technically, I'm still in the right of doing that. But yeah, this is how this one tool has clutched my entire university life. You may wonder to yourself, why don't you just bring your own laptop? Well, that's because my laptop battery was dead at the time. Yeah, about that, you can see where I was going with that. But yeah, I don't think there's not much for me to yap about and show about, but it is something that I would like to show and tell and yap about, primarily because I think it's worth showing and it's kind of a cool concept, in my opinion. So that's pretty much it. With that said, thank you all so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe, be sure to press like, notification bell. Want more tech videos? Check out my videos tab. If you want more gaming, check out the live tab. And if you want to hang out with me, check out the Discord, and we probably talk about a lot of different stuff and stuff like that. If you would like to support me financially, check out my Ko-fi, because none of these, like the computer I'm using, the equipment I'm using, is free. So hopefully we can be financially sustainable to be able to maintain all these hardware that I'm currently using for filming. But anyways, with that said, thank you all so much for watching, and otsumeno deshita. See ya! Have a good day or night or whatever the time zone is at your place. See ya! Top down camera done. I almost dropped the fucking camera. I'm not dropping that camera ever again.